back, everyone. Have you been to your local home improvement store lately and walked near the paint aisles? The color selection area is incredible. Choosing a color for our home painting needs can seem overwhelming as there are so many from which to choose. But have you ever thought about the history behind cars and paint? How do cars get their colors? Paint is one of the most important design aspects of a car. Paint companies hold annual color shows where all the new colors are presented to the automotive designers and stylists. It must be difficult to choose the best new colors with so many options. So today, let's look at some history of automotive paint as well as its influence on Corvettes and color. What colors have been popular over time? Maybe red or blue, or maybe black or white. Let's find out together. When Henry Ford's Model Ts first went on sale in 1908, they were painted red, then later dark green and blue. The paint that Ford put on his first model cars was not automotive paint at all. The paint was applied by hand brushing and multiple coats, and this process took several days to complete, making production of each vehicle a longer time frame. By the mid to late 1920s, the opportunity to choose more vehicle colors also introduced the concept of color styling across the automotive industry. It was adopted and soon put into practice. Mr. Alfred Sloan, who became General Motors president in May 1923, believed that consumers buying lower-priced cars would appreciate a range of color choices, especially if the paints were long-lasting. Also, the 1920s brought with it the introduction to spray painting when, in 1924, paint spray guns made their way into the world of auto painting, and they soon made their appearance on assembly lines. Now, let's fast forward a few decades to Corvette's first generation and talk about color options and how they grew as the years passed. We learned last season in Vettecademy that all 300 Corvettes built in 1953 had polo white fiberglass bodies. Because there wasn't any sort of body color data until 1962, at the end of the first generation, the factory's data was lacking on exact shipments and colors during that whole time period and can only be confirmed by an original window sticker. In 1954, of the 3,640 cars that were produced, about 3,200 of them were still polo white. Three additional options included pennant blue, sportsman red, and black. The rest of the first generation saw a variety of colors come and go. Harvest gold and Corvette copper were new options in 1955. By 1956, the lineup included Venetian red, onyx black, Aztec copper, Arctic blue, and Cascade green. Inca silver joined Corvette's palette in 1957. Panama yellow was introduced in 1958, along with Snowcrest white, Signet red, Silver blue, Regal turquoise, and charcoal. Tuxedo black, Frost blue, Roman red, Crown sapphire, and Classic cream came along in 1959, and in 1960, new options included Tasco turquoise, Horizon blue, Honduras maroon, Ermine white, and Sateen silver. 1961 brought us Jewel blue and Fawn beige. And finally, the end of the first generation in 1962 brought one more beige option with it, almond beige. Yes, there are seven more generations worth of all kinds of color options, but today we are only going to focus on my personal favorite color, blue. Maybe blue is your favorite color as well. Do you know that over the years, Corvette has had roughly 40 versions of blue body color options? Corvette's second generation began in 1963 and ended in 1967. Some of the blues that showed up during the C2 generation were Daytona blue, Nassau blue, Laguna blue, Trophy, Marine, and Lindale blue, and Elkhart blue. 1968 through 1982 ushered in the C3 era. Remember that the third generation was also the longest. 16 blue options made their debut during the third generation. If you watched last season of Vettecademy, you may also remember that 1981 was the last year Corvettes were built in St. Louis, Missouri, while it was also the first year Corvettes were built at the Bowling Green, Kentucky assembly plant. One way to recognize this switch on actual Corvettes built in this year is to look at the car's vehicle identification number, or VIN for short. The VIN recognized this location change by switching the S for the car's assembly location in St. Louis to a 5 within the VIN number, recognizing Bowling Green. In addition, with the Corvette production moving to Bowling Green, they could now better handle two-tone paints with a base coat, clear coat setup. In 1981, some new blue metallic showed up with bright blue metallic and dark blue metallic. The fourth generation spanned from 1984 to 1996 and added some new names to the Blue Option family of colors. Colors like light blue metallic, steel blue metallic, quasar blue metallic, and admiral blue were added. Moving on to 1997 through 2004, Corvette's fifth generation showcased blues such as Nassau blue metallic, Electron blue, and Le Mans blue. The sixth generation spanned from 2005 to 2013, and four new blue options included Jetstream blue, Supersonic blue, Carlisle blue, and Night Race blue made their appearance. In addition to Elkhart Lake blue and Admiral blue, Corvette's seventh generation, which ran from 2014 to 2019, also brought along with it Laguna blue tint coat and Sterling blue. As of June 2020, the most popular colors for the new 8th generation or C8 mid-engine Corvette are Torch Red, Arctic White, and Black. But Elkhart Lake Blue Metallic and Rapid Blue are some of the next popular. When all is said and done, paint systems today are better than ever, and the colors from which to choose are beautiful as well. Of course, the methods of applying car paint have also evolved from hand painting to fully automated machines. In May of 2015, a groundbreaking ceremony was held for the new expanded General Motors Bowling Green Corvette Assembly Paint Shop. It is massive at 897,000 total square feet. The project was completed in 2017, and the first painted vehicle came off the line in April of that year. Automotive designers understand that being on top of future trends in color is very important to developing a successful color palette for their vehicle lines. The colors they select must not only give their vehicle a unique identity on the roadways, but also must be well-liked by a wide range of potential buyers. Recently, we were introduced to two new colors for the 2021 Corvettes: Blade Silver Metallic and Red Mist Tint Coat Metallic. Who knows what colors may be bursting onto our roads in the future? So, what color would you choose for your Corvette? Tune in next week when we check out some history behind Corvettes and racing.